Welcome to the Inventory Source Podcast. With 15 years of experience in e-commerce, dropshipping, and data automation, we bring you notable insight and knowledge of e-commerce and tech from industry experts.
All right. Hey, everyone. This is Austin with Inventory Source, bringing you guys another podcast your way. Another podcast here that we're super excited about. We're going to be spotlighting one of our top suppliers, Educators Resource. These guys are awesome. They do some great customer service, but really they have a huge product line in regards to school supplies and office supplies. And I mean, that's like the main industry, but there's so much more that they provide as well. I'm going to hand that on over to Frank, and he's going to explain a little bit more about us. About them. So I've got Frank here with me from Educators Resource. Hey, Frank, man, thanks for joining. I appreciate it.
Hello, everyone. This is Frank Trice. I'm the sales manager for Educators Resource. And Austin, it's nice to talk to you this morning. I'd love to tell you a little bit more about our company.
Yeah, absolutely. Super pumped about this. We've got a great relationship with Frank and Educators Resource over there. So super excited about this. To get us started, you know, Frank, just give me a good high level background about Educators Resource, how you guys got started, you know, what you guys are currently doing now, and everything in between.
Sure. So Educators Resource, you know, we weren't just born yesterday. We've been around for over 40 years. We started off as a wholesale distributor of pens is how we got started down here in we're located in the Mobile, Alabama area, and we're a wholesaler of pens. And in 1993, we transitioned to full educational supplies and became a wholesale distributor in that regard. We had one other company that was competing against us in that area, and we have recently purchased them. So we are the leading wholesale distributor of anything that goes in a classroom other than technology and furniture. So anytime you walk into a kid's classroom, most of the stuff in there will be something that was distributed by Educators Resource. So we are basically our K through 12 is really our focus. We have a lot of other products as well that are kind of interesting, especially for the fourth quarter that is coming up rapidly.
Awesome. Awesome. No, that's a good background about you guys. You know, you guys are very specific to the school supplies industry. And I mean, that's some really cool stuff because, you know, being in a family where I have teachers all in my family, you know, it's the biggest thing that I've hear is about getting school supplies, you know, getting the right stuff and making sure classes are all stocked up for everything that they need to help educate, you know, our youth. But that's great. Great overview. Going off of that, you know, what's some accomplishments that you guys have been able to achieve this past year in 2018?
Sure. Well, just recently, we've worked very hard on efficiencies through our warehouse and through our in our office as well. So we use some co-op money from UPS. We're the second largest shipper of UPS in the Metro Mobile area. So that allows us some co-op dollars that we were very happy to spend in our warehouse updating. They sent some consultants to our warehouse and basically came up with a plan to make it very efficient. So we were able to buy this really nice forklift that runs on a wire that allows us to put our aisles closer together. What that means for your customers is that we can have more products and we have more room in our 90,000 square foot warehouse. And then basically made these narrow. It's really pretty neat. And then so we've also were able to add 40 new packing and shipping stations. So we had four packing stations before. Now we have went to 40, and each packing station has a shipping station as well. So we can do all the labels, packing lists, everything. And then we put in a very high efficiency conveyor system that runs upstairs to our mezzanine and then back down with a little nice little slide. So all the products move very quickly to that UPS truck. So we're loading an entire UPS truck every day and some FedEx as well. So that was kind of a really much needed upgrade. We also went to biodegradable air pillows for all our products, which are also recyclable. So, you know, as much packaging that goes with it, at least it can be recycled and actually is biodegradable if it needs to be thrown away. Then we upgraded all of our hardware both inside and outside the office. So our pickers are using handheld scanners. So we increase the Wi-Fi capabilities for the scanners so that there's no dead spots when they're picking products. And we've been able to update all the servers in the computers on the inside so that we can do end of day processing. It used to take 4 to 5 hours to process a day's of work. Now it takes like 30 minutes. So these were huge advancements for us and has been, I think, very good for all of our e-commerce customers.
Yeah, that sounds awesome. That's definitely going to help out. You know, and that turnaround time just gives you guys more time to focus on some, you know, probably more important stuff. So, no, that's some really cool stuff that you guys got going for you there. And that kind of takes me into a next question of, you started talking a little bit about the products that you guys provide, yeah. And then providing that throughout the year. I had a quick question where obviously back to school grind, right? Coming towards the end of summer. And then once school starts up is probably the, like, in my eyes, the biggest part of the year for you guys. I'm really curious, since we're coming into the holidays, are you guys focused on the holidays as almost just as important as back to school? How do those kind of factor into each other?
Yeah. So when I started working here 10 years ago and we just had one big season, it was back to school. Started up in July and went to September. And then, you know, we had a lot of pickers and packers that came in. And then we dropped them all off at September. They'd start other jobs. Now we kind of get ramped up in June or July, and we go all the way through till January. So it's really one big season. Fourth quarter is very important to us now. We have a lot of educational toys, lots of STEM and STEAM type products. Science, technology, education, math, or engineering, math, excuse me, that are really kind of neat Christmas presents, holiday presents as well. So we're finding that there's not much of a drop off. We're spending all of October bringing in those sort of products and getting ready. And then, of course, you know, we got Black Friday coming up and very, very quickly. And that's just become, obviously, we're seeing about a 30% increase every year in our Black Friday sales. So we're bringing people in on Friday to actually pick products. So we're ready to ship out on Monday when UPS is ready. So it's become huge for us, and we're happy to have the business.
Okay. Yeah. No, that makes a lot of sense. Like I said, I know with the families, the teachers in my family, it doesn't matter if it's, you know, back to school, if it's October, if it's January, if it's March, you know, obviously school winding up then, but like there's always going to be a need for school supplies. So that makes a lot of sense. And you mentioned some new lines, I think you said coming out Q4, or, you know, I'm just curious, obviously a lot of listeners out there, if they want to get started up with Educators Resource, it's probably important to, you know, talk a little bit more about the products that you guys offer. So obviously it's K-12 products. What's some new, maybe innovative products that you guys have added that you guys are super excited about?
Well, you know, like I say, anything science oriented is really our focus. It's what our biggest customers are asking for. So anything that's kind of robot oriented or engineering oriented, and I can't really speak specifically to any of the products, and I'm not really a product person per se. But just to give you an idea, we have over 300 different vendors. These are all major vendors in the education space. We have 21,000 products, and I would say probably 2,000 or 3,000 of those would be toy oriented. So lots of and lots of into the fun things, just like dolls, and lots of the younger kids stuff, play toys, like when they're role playing type stuff. So you know, costumes and all sorts of different things like that that any child would want. I have a 6-year-old and a 9-year-old, and so I've worked here the entire time as my children have grown up, and it's been perfect for the holidays to have this resource here for my own purposes, even. So we sell Champion Sports. We have a full line of athletic products as well. So lots of balls and any sort of PE type things. So just kind of anything that you could possibly want for the holidays, we have it. But you know, some of those high tech sort of robot and that sort of thing is obviously really popular.
That's cool. Yeah, I didn't even really think about that that specific type of product, right? That's some really cool stuff. And I know that, you know, everybody's going to have to adapt to you know, how we're moving to everything that's tech, right? Everybody's got a cell phone. Everybody's got, you know, or wanting some type of automation if they're in e-commerce. Obviously, we see that. So that's really cool that you guys are obviously adapting to that and bringing on those products that make sense. But obviously, I don't think anybody's ever going to get away from highlighters and pencils and paper and all the basic stuff, you know, that teachers need. I, like I said, I see it all the time. So, That makes a lot of sense. And I guess that's a pretty good transition into tech challenges that, you know, your dealers and retailers probably see on a daily basis. And obviously, you know, we come into play and we're going to help with the automation functionality for some of those guys that might be not too tech savvy, keeping products on their site, keeping them up to date with inventory, helping out with the automated ordering process. But, you know, from a tech challenge perspective, you know, how often do you see this with the customers that you talk to in regards to making sure everything's as seamless as possible whenever these guys are either starting with Educators Resource, if they're doing either just wholesaling or drop shipping? You know, what tech challenges do you guys see? And do you see, you know, just a huge trend when it comes to that?
Sure. So, you know, we find that working with a company like Educators Resource and getting our products onto your website, it's a pretty sophisticated process. You really need to have some sort of background. But we have many newbies or people that are just kind of new to the whole process that want to add, you know, our 21,000 products. And you need to have some certain skills using FTP clients to access all of our products. We have everything deconstructed, which can be great for maybe a company like Inventory Source to use, but a little more challenging for someone who's just kind of gotten into the field. So anytime I'm talking to a customer that maybe doesn't seem, you know, it's kind of new to the process, we always want to reach out to Inventory Source if they can help them out. And so that's been great. We also have some challenges with, we have a small percentage of vendors that are not able to be sold on third-party marketplaces such as Amazon or eBay. An Inventory Source is invaluable in this process to keep our customers from getting in trouble with Amazon. So if they accidentally listed products from a vendor that they weren't supposed to, Inventory Source basically keeps them keeps those products off of those different channels. So we really, really like that, and you guys are invaluable in helping us with that.
Yeah, absolutely. That's huge, especially those marketplace sellers, man. That's massive. And, you know, we see that a lot. And that kind of, you know, one thing that popped in my head in regards to kind of staying on the topic of e-commerce and getting started online, getting started selling Educators Resource products is, I'm assuming you guys have a lot of brick and mortar stores, right? You have the big box retailers, you have the small kind of one-man operations, and I'm sure you guys have brick and mortars that do maybe some wholesale buying from you guys. Have you seen a huge trend of them trying to get into e-commerce? How much do they utilize drop shipping? And what's the conversation there between you guys and these brick and mortar stores looking to get on e-commerce?
That's a great question. So 10 years ago, when I first started here, we were 90% brick and mortar. So there's mom and pop stores and larger stores throughout the entire country that were utilizing us, buying $500 of $1,000 of a product at a time, ordering weekly. That's what we were designed for, fulfilling these type of orders. Now we get, you know, $1,030 orders every day going out for these e-commerce customers. But the more savvy of these brick and mortars, they started their own websites, of course, and we started servicing those type customers in 1997. So we were like one of the, you know, first people that were actually fulfilling e-commerce orders for these brick and mortar stores. And they would fulfill something at some products out of their store and some from us. And so that's really how we got into the game. Now more and more of them, the ones that had three or four stores, they might have one store that they're working from and maybe a warehouse, and then they're utilizing us primarily for all of their e-commerce orders. They're not trying to fulfill that out of their store. It's not efficient at all. So we've seen a huge transition in 10 years. And so now we're 90% e-commerce, 10% brick and mortar and catalog sales. So it's unbelievable how much the world has changed in such a short period of time.
Yeah, and that's a huge thing that I've talked about with other suppliers is, you know, some of these guys, they're just going to have to adapt. Unfortunately, that's just kind of the name of the game. Everybody's buying online. Everybody's got a cell phone. Everybody's got, you know, looking on Amazon to buy products, and you need to compete. So obviously, that makes a lot of sense that you guys see that. So one thing that I was, you know, really curious about, and I love asking our suppliers and just seeing what's going on since we're wrapping up. We're now into November, so we're into the holiday season. Things are are probably, you know, you guys have back to school, but things are still probably crazy in the holiday season. You know, what are we excited about towards the end of the year? And then what's something that you can speak on that should get your retailers and dealers and, you know, potential new dealers excited about for 2019?
Sure. Well, you know, our main thing is in to service all of our customers, including our inventory source customers, is to have enhanced content. So I guess we had like about three people in our digital merchandising area just 2 years ago. Now we're like at about eight. And I don't see an end where we keep adding people to our digital merchandising part of our company. And I mean, it's not sexy to talk about, but this data that we have to have, all these images, all the descriptions, all these different fields that have to be filled out for enhanced content, including like the prop, the California props that you have to have different, if there's a chemical, harmful chemical, something like that, all this data has to be managed. It has to be retrieved from some of our slower vendors who are maybe not quite in the 21st century. You know, all the products that are made in China and different places like that, we have to, you know, make sure that we're properly denoting their country of origin. You know, one of the biggest hurdles recently, kind of with the political landscape, is that there's going to be new tariffs starting in January for Chinese products. So we're seeing some kind of price increases for those products. So it'll be really interesting to see how that shakes out as far as our products made different places. We will be attending some trade shows at the beginning of the year where we're meeting with new vendors. And we're always looking to bring in new products. And once again, we've been mandated by our customers, anything STEM related, science, technology stuff, we need to bring more of those products.
Yeah, so that's some, you know, that's some really important stuff that you hit on there, Frank, about the tariffs and everything that we got to look out for next year. I've been hearing that with a lot of suppliers, and you know, really some important stuff in regards to you know, the shipping times and things like that. That's one thing that, you know, I wanted to hit on with Educators Resource. I want to highlight you guys. You guys do awesome in regards to getting products out shipped on time, and a lot of suppliers aren't very, you know, aren't there all the time when it comes to that stuff. You guys kill the competition there, which is great. And then, you know, really one thing I wanted to hit on before we jump off here is you guys give great customer service, you know, always looping us in where it makes sense, always reaching out to us if there has been issues so we can help troubleshoot. And then if we run into any issues, when we reach out to you guys are very quick on a response time. That is, I feel like, number one that retailers and dealers look for when it comes to a good partner to work with for drop shipping. So definitely want to highlight you guys there. That's some awesome stuff that you have, that your team really, you know, kills it in regards to that. Other than that, you know, that's about all I have in regards. We got some great content here in regards to Educators Resource and learning more about you guys. You have anything else before we jump off, Frank?
No, I just can't wait to grow this relationship. It's been wonderful working with you guys over the past year and a half or so. So I just look forward to growing this and providing, you know, world-class fulfillment for your customers.
Yeah, absolutely, Frank. Super excited about it. Like you said, we have a great relationship going forward. So thanks again, man. I really appreciate everybody out there listening. Go check out Educators Resource. They have a great product selection, great customer service, shipping times, fulfillment, everything there. They really know what they're doing. You know, they've been doing it for a very long time. So go check them out. And then check out any more podcasts. We've got a handful of new suppliers and partnership podcasts we're going to be reaching out here. Frank, thanks again. Everybody, awesome. Stay tuned for the next one.
Appreciate it.
All right. See you.
Bye.